أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الذي خلق الإنسان في أحسن تقويم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم علي من اتبع الهدى. Praise be to Allah, the exalted, the sustainer of all the worlds, and we created man in the best stature mold. Blessings and peace be upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last of all the prophets and messengers, and on the members of his family, his companions, and on all those who follow him until the day of resurrection. Greetings of peace to those who are on the right path. And we must also show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us hidayah or guidance in Islam. This is a great mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator and the sustainer. But many of the ummah take it for granted. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us wisdom and to be always thankful with his countless blessings. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is Ruwayd bin Abdul Rashid, also known Muhammad Ruwayd bin Saifullah, recording the Daily Reminder Network. We seem to be unique from the other youths who are not involved in this kind of gatherings. We see youths around us in our societies who have no concern of seeking knowledge. They don't worry about their future. This is explicitly happening around the world. It is not just in Cotabato, Mindanao, Philippines, or Asia, but around the globe. This matter is alarming. We cannot just sit there and stare at things. We have got to do something. Before doing so, we should equip ourselves to be good citizens. We have got to prepare ourselves to be at least qualified leaders. Why ourselves? First, as the Arab poet said, فَكِرْ شَيْءٍ لَا يُعْطِيهِ, which means you cannot give what you don't have. Do you think, are we able to give something which we don't possess? It is a big no. So that at this point in time, our role is to focus in our studies, so that in the near future we will be equipped and ready to surmount the hardships, inshallah ta'ala. I suppose that you get my very point here. What is it? It is education. No one can deny it. I am sure, without fear of objection from anybody else, that being educated, aware of, and knowing something beneficial individually and collectively is mandatory upon all of us. Mandatory upon all of us. In Islamic point of view, its ruling is farz and obligatory. To sustain this, the Quran and the Sunnah and some well-known personalities have agreed about the importance of seeking knowledge. The Quran first, only one evidence is enough. The first verse revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, was Iqra, which means to read, to recite, and to pray. So it is directly or indirectly commanding us to seek knowledge. The Sunnah is the second. I will first give you the definition of the Arabic word Sunnah. It means the sayings, actions, attitudes, traditions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, and his Sahaba or companions. He said, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلمين. It means seeking knowledge is obligatory upon every Muslim. I know that we have been dreaming of ultimate peace. We say, when will I feel tranquility or sakina, peace of mind, and so on? It has been the dream of the Bang Samuro long ago. We cannot deny it, but we tend not to realize what Allah is seeing. Allah said in Surah Wa'ad, chapter 13, verse 28, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَطَمَئِنَّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ طَمَئِنَّ قُلُوبُ, which means those who believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whose hearts find rest in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily in the remembrance of Allah do hearts and find rest. So real happiness and peace can only be found in submitting to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This may explain why some people commit suicide while they enjoy material comfort money can buy. For example, look at Cat Stevens, now Yusuf Islam, formerly a famous pop singer who can earn sometimes more than $150,000 a night. So you see, that is more than 6 million pesos. So you can read a brief illustrated guide to understanding Islam, page 43, you'll find it, the history. So we have to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek knowledge, act according to the teachings of Islam before we could change the condition of the Bang Samuro. In short, we must rectify or correct our akida first before anything else. We must ask ourselves, and I'm on the right manhaj? Am I on the right methodology in practicing the teachings of Islam? I'm on the way of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah? What is my way? So it goes back to the seeking of knowledge. Studying the Dinul Islam is the priority. Studying the Dinul Islam is the priority. Compare the studying of secular with religion. In secular, many times we spend many days, but what about the Islam that can lead us to be the ultimate success? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us intellect. Thirdly, Confucius said to know what you know and know what you don't know. It is the characteristic of one who knows. So, I pray that we also have benefited and that we use what we have learned today in our lives to help make a difference in the future progress and development. And we hope that Allah give us all success in our future, both here in the next life. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who bestows success and guides to the straight path. Shukran lakum, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah be in all of you.